I'm Zoe Daniel.
I'm Allegra Spender.
I'm Sophie Scomps.
My name's Kylie Ting.
And I'm your community-backed...
Independent
candidate.
Our climate is changing.
Let's change the climate in Canberra.
After a year of reckoning for women, and with an election around the corner, there's now a push to change the makeup of federal parliament itself. But the odds of more independent MPs getting elected are pretty slim.
Why you?
Look, I think, like so many people in Wentworth, I'm really frustrated with the current government in terms of climate, in terms of integrity, in terms of the economy, and also in terms of women.
Allegra Spender is the daughter of the late fashion icon Carla Zampatti, and her Liberal roots run deep. Her grandfather served under Menzies, and her dad was the federal member for North Sydney.
So you've got the Liberal Party in your blood?
Yeah. I've worn a lot of Liberal Party T-shirts in my time.
Now, Allegra is running as an independent in Wentworth against the Liberals' Dave Sharma, who holds the seat by a slender 1.3%. Her campaign office directly across the road from his.
Dave Sharma's had 3 years, and we've still got Tony Abbott's climate targets.
Who are the independents targeting? They're targeting Liberals, moderate Liberals in metropolitan seats. So if their prescription is we want the Liberal Party to be more moderate or more mainstream, they're targeting the very people that are dragging it in that direction.
I think the moderates have said, you know, all sorts of things, but actually when it comes to what they vote for, they don't vote that. They vote the way that the Nationals do on climate, on integrity. Those are the things that they actually do, and they don't seem to be willing to really push their agenda.
In Melbourne's Kooyong, another wealthy inner city electorate, it's Treasurer Josh Frydenberg who's being targeted. He holds the seat with a margin of more than 5%.
I'm a paediatric neurologist, which means I'm a baby brain doctor. I work at the Children's Hospital in Melbourne. I'm head of the department there.
And so what happens to that job while you run?
I have to leave it. And so I actually resigned on Monday. For me to walk away from a job that I truly love, to which I've been very committed for 15 years, was a very, very difficult thing. It was a dreadful decision to have to make. But I just felt that I had no choice. I had to do something.
So what's your political background?
I have none. I'm a clean skin.
Monique admits she was a member of the Labor Party for 3 years, but she quit in 2010 when Kevin Rudd went soft on climate change.
Your opponents will say you're a Labor person.
Yes. I'm not wearing the same jumpers I was wearing 10 years ago. I'm not. I'm just simply not. I'm not a tool of any person or any faction. I don't have to toe any party lines. I am a true independent. And that gives me a lot of freedom.
The government, though, says you're only targeting them. You're only targeting Liberals.
Well, they're the government.
What's wrong with Josh Frydenberg? Isn't he one of the moderates in the room, one of the sensible voices arguing for action on climate change?
Josh Frydenberg is probably a nice person. I've not met him and I don't know him. But he has been a member of that government for 11 years, and that government has failed us, and that's why I'm standing against him.
Other independents making a stand include former ABC foreign correspondent Zoe Daniel, taking on Tim Wilson. In McKellar, local GP Sophie Scomps is making waves against Jason Falinski, and charity boss Kylie Tink is challenging Trent Zimmerman in North Sydney.
Why do you believe they're only targeting moderate Liberals?
Ultimately, their agenda is against the government, against Liberal National Government. I mean, if you're independent, why are you only targeting Liberals? If you believe in the three issues, do you think Labor's policies are fine on those?
Dave Sharma has already fought two elections against the independent, Karen Phelps.
What's different about running against an independent as opposed to running against a Labor candidate as your sort of primary opponent?
They tend to have the freedom to be all things to all people, because they don't have to offer policies on all issues.
Do the moderate Liberals, though, make enough noise?
We've all been very, I think, vocal voices. Does it mean we get everything our own way? No, but that's part of the nature of being part of a team.
On climate change, Allegra Spender says Sharma should have pushed harder to meet more ambitious targets before 2030.
Dave, I don't believe that you're proud of our 2030 target.
Well, I'm supportive of a more ambitious interim target. I'm supportive of net zero by 2050. I'm on the record of supporting a more ambitious 2035 target.
You know, there could be a hung parliament. It could be a minority coalition government.
The last time we had a hung parliament and independents holding the balance of power was the Gillard government from 2010 to 2013. Now, if that's people's prescription saying this is an ideal scenario, that we're going to create gridlock and we're going to have independents holding the country to ransom on pet projects and single issues, I think that's a recipe for poor governance.
They're running on integrity, better treatment of women in our federal parliament and politics more broadly, and climate change. They're not pet projects or single issues.
They're not, but I would say that the most important job of any government is to protect its citizens' security and its welfare. That's what a federal government is there to do, to keep the country safe, to keep people in jobs and employed. And if you're not doing those two things, nothing else can happen.
Many of the independents are being backed by Climate 200, a fundraising group with deep pockets, which claims Australia's political system is too broken to tackle climate change.
What's the connection between your campaign and Climate 200? How does that work?
Climate 200, which is run by Simon Holmes, the court has committed to supporting grassroots campaigns, but he's not the major donor and he's not the only donor by any means.
We'll get some money from Climate 200, but the vast majority is coming from this local community and their deep frustration.
I think any candidate that's being selected by a committee and that's being orchestrated from another state and funded by, some people who've inherited a large amount of wealth, that doesn't look very organic or grassroots to me. It's clear that Simon Holmes Accord and the Climate 200 movement, I mean, this is a de facto political party.
Zoe Daniels certainly isn't embarrassed by Holmes Accord's riches.
Climate 200 is offering to donate $100,000 if we can match it.
I suppose it's very noticeable that all of these independent candidates that are running are women. Does that tell us something about the Prime Minister standing with women?
Well, look, I would say that I'm a supporter of more diversity in the parliament, but I also think diversity goes beyond gender. I'm the first Indian Australian in the House of Representatives.
Why are you all women?
There is a tendency when you're a 50-year-old-ish woman to look at a mess and think, just give it to me. I'll fix it up. And I think that's what we're all thinking. Give it to me and I'll fix it up.
And they've got a very big job ahead of them because there's a lot to fix.
I don't think there's any denying it needs some fixing, right?
But what an irony after the year that we've had when it comes to women's issues in this country, that the biggest threat to Scott Morrison being returned as Prime Minister is independent women. Mm.
It could well be.
I think strong women have really changed the political landscape this year. And he genuinely looks kind of scared, Dave Sharma, don't you reckon? I think he sees these independent candidates as like a real threat.
It's a small margin that he's on. Some of them are facing much bigger margins to overcome. But even if they don't all win, this could have a very big impact on the outcome of the federal election. Mm.